हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. आई एम गौरव गुप्ता एज योर मैथमेटिक्स टीचर. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस और स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर फोर फ्रॉम एलिमेंट मैथमेटिक्स. दिस चैप्टर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एज वेल एज योर कॉम्पिटिशन लाइक जेई एडवांस एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम लाइक NDA. So this section is why important for your examination point of view, because this section has some question which carries 6 marks as well as 1 marks and 2 marks which are very important. So the chapter name is determinants. So firstly we have to clear about the determinants. What is determinants? Basically determinants it's a scalar value that we calculate from a square matrix. It means you keep in mind whenever we calculate the determinant is only possible of a square matrix, not any other matrix like row matrix, column matrix, rectangular matrix and so on. So keep in mind determinant is calculated only for the square matrix and it gives a scalar value that we have to calculate from a square matrix. And square matrix contains so many linear equations. So we have to calculate a scalar value which encode different algebra or different equations. We have to encode them. So we start our first topic, which is determinant, and how we calculate the determinants. Determinants, we have firstly we have to take example of square matrix of order 2, and how we calculate the determinant. Let's see. Determinants. Suppose we are taking a matrix A, 2, 3, 4, 9, and we have to calculate its determinant. Firstly, keep in mind what's the representation of a matrix or a determinant, because some students have a confusion to write determinant or in terms of a matrix. This is a matrix, but we have to calculate its determinant. How we represent it? We use two parallel lines to represent determinant, same as in terms of matrix. Here we use square brackets, but in this case we use parallel lines. 2, 3, 4, and 9. Now how we calculate its determinants? Method is very simple. Firstly, you have to go forward cross multiply, then minus reverse cross multiply. Forward means we have go, next step means we go forward, and reverse means we are going to back. So cross means we have used cross multiplications. So in this is your forward and this one is your reverse. So we have to use forward cross multiply. So in this we have to multiply 2 multiply by 9. We get 18. Now minus reverse cross multiply, 3 fourths of 12. It means 18 minus 12 is your 6, which is your final answer. It's very simple. We have firstly we use forward cross minus reverse cross multiply, that will be the determinant. How to solve the determinants? This is for your 2 cross 2 matrix. Clear? Again I repeat, this is the method for your square matrix. It means square matrix have the order 2 into 2, 3 into 3, 4 into 4, but here we take an example of 2 into 2. I hope this will be clear to you. Now we take another example. Please make a loop first. Now we take an example of square matrix of order 3 cross 3. This one is your example. Let me take a matrix A has an elements this. Now we have to calculate the determinants. How we calculate some method? Firstly, we have to represent A parallel lines 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 1, 2. Now, whenever we solve the determinants, we have choice. What are the choice? Determinant is solved either one row or one column. It means we have an option to use row operations as well as column operations. But we have used only one at a time. And row or column, how we choose? The determinant can be solved by expanding along any row or any column. Firstly, you have to select where on which you apply the determinant method, or you expand on which row or which column. Firstly, you have to decide the determinants will be same to expand either any row or any columns. We take two examples. Firstly, I take an example to expand along row first. Expand along R1. R1 stands for row first. This is your first row. Simplest method is firstly you write the numbers. Here is 1, here is 2, and here is 1. Now you have used the sign. And how we choose the sign and what are the signs of the remaining elements, I will tell you later. Firstly, you know, if we expand along R1, what are the signs we have to take? First sign is positive, second sign is negative, and third sign is positive. Again, I repeat, firstly, you write the numbers. Whatever the number positive or negative, you have to write. So, I write 1, 2, and 1. If number 2 is negative, then we write here 2 as negative. So I change, suppose here I take 2 as negative. So it means 2 is negative. Now take a bracket to all these numbers and use sign according to this convention. First your sign is positive, second sign is negative, and third sign is positive. Okay, first sign is positive, negative, and positive. Now draw two parallel lines. This is your 2 cross 2 determinants. And how, what are the elements that we will put in this? Firstly, we have take 1. So whenever you choose any elements, you have to cross that row as well as that column. Again, which element that you are choose, cross that row and that column. Here we choose 1. So we have to cross that row. Row means we have to cross this. And column, this one is your column. And write the remaining elements. So remaining elements are 2, 4, 1, 2. Again, now our second element is minus 2. Here is minus 2. Now repeat the step. Firstly, you because we are choosing negative 2. So you have to cross negative 2 and cross row. We cross the row as well as column. Then what are the remaining elements? 3, फाइव फोर टू. इन सिमिलर मैनर टेक थर्ड एलिमेंट इज वन, दिस वन. इफ वी क्रॉस दिस रो, इट मीन्स वी हैव क्रॉस दिस रो एंड क्रॉस कॉलम, क्रॉस दिस कॉलम, देन व्हाट वी आर गेट, we are getting here 3, 2, 5 and 1. 3, 2, 5 and 1. Simply we expand determinant along any row or any column. Whenever we solving our determinants, firstly you write the number, then take convention positive, negative and positive, then take 1 by 1 elements. Suppose if we have choose first element, then cross that row and that columns, and remaining elements we have to put here. Similarly, we have to choose second, similarly third. We get here. Now this is your 2 cross 2 determinant, and the method is as we already discussed. Now apply it. Positive 1, 2 cross 2 is 4, minus 4 into 1, 4, negative negative, positive, 3 into 2, 6, minus 4 into 5, 20, plus 1, 3 into 1, 3, negative, 5 into 2, 10. Now solve it. This one is your 0, plus 2, 6 minus 20, minus 14, plus 1, 3 minus 10, which is equal to minus 7, 2 into minus 14, minus 28, minus 7, which is equal to minus 35. This one is your final answer. Please make a note. Now we take the same example, but now we expand in different along different row or different column. In first we have take R1, first row, expand along row. Now we take another row, or we can choose any column. So let me take an example to expand along its any column. Let me take an first column, or you can, it's your option, you can choose any. Suppose we have here to choose your first column and expand the determinant along C1. Firstly, you have to know about the convention. In first case, I write plus minus plus. Whenever you solve the determinant, you have the convention, that is, first convention is your positive. It means to start your first element, take as positive signs. And alternate, positive and negative. Now continuously two positive or negative come together. Keep in mind, never two positive or two negative will come together. We use alternate, positive, negative, positive, negative. So start from positive. We have start from positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. This sign help you whenever you expand along which one row, R1 row, R2 row, R3, C1, C2 and C3. So we are here taking C1. So we use the sign convention as positive, negative and positive. The method is same. Firstly, you have to write the elements. Here elements is 1, 3 and 5. We take 1, 3, 5. Now it takes sign positive, negative and positive. So it means this one is your positive, negative, positive. Now use parallel lines. Same process, we have used first elements, so we have to cross that row as well as that column. If we cross this row, it means we are using this row, cross, we cross this row and this column. What are the remaining elements? 2, 4, 1, 2, right, 2, 4, 1, 2. सेकेंड वन जो है एलिमेंट इज थ्री बिकॉज वी एक्सपेंडिंग अलोंग सी वन योर सेकेंड एलिमेंट इज थ्री सो क्रॉस दैट रो एज वेल एज दैट कॉलम वट आर द रिमेनिंग एलिमेंट्स माइनस टू वन वन टू नाउ सेम प्रोसेस फॉर थर्ड एलिमेंट दिस इज योर थर्ड एलिमेंट्स क्रॉस दैट रो एंड दैट कॉलम वट आर द रिमेनिंग एलिमेंट्स माइनस टू टू वन एंड फोर वन एंड फोर नाउ सॉल्व इट वन टू इंटू टू फोर माइनस फोर इंटू वन फोर नेगेटिव थ्री माइनस टू इंटू टू माइनस फोर वन इंटू वन माइनस फोर प्लस फाइव माइनस टू इंटू फोर माइनस एट माइनस टू इंटू वन टू फोर माइनस फोर जीरो नेगेटिव थ्री माइनस फोर माइनस वन माइनस फाइव प्लस फाइव माइनस एट माइनस टू माइनस टेन माइनस थ्री इंटू माइनस फाइव प्लस फिफ्टीन प्लस फाइव इंटू टेन माइनस फिफ्टीन प्लस फिफ्टीन माइनस फिफ्टीन विच इज इक्वल टू माइनस थर्टी फाइव योर सेम आंसर सो इट्स योर चॉइस टू एक्सपेंड एनी रो एनी कॉलम बट टेक साइन कन्वेंशन अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस मैट्रिक्स द आंसर विल बी सेम द मोस्ट कन्वीनियंट मेथड इज टू एक्सपेंड आर वन मोस्ट ऑफ द बुक्स कैरी फर्स्ट एजम्पशन टू एक्सपेंड अलोंग फर्स्ट रो बट इफ द क्वेश्चन मेंशन एक्सपेंड अलोंग वन आर वन आर टू एंड आर थ्री देन इट्स योर ड्यूटी टू इवेल्युएट or expand along that row. I hope this will be clear to you. Please make a note. Now our next topic is minor. How we calculate the minor as well as cofactor. How we calculate the minor as well as cofactor. Please look. This one is your matrix A, which has elements 2, 3, 4 and 1. Minor is calculated for each element. Same as cofactor is calculated for your each elements, not for a matrices. We have calculate minors of each matrix and cofactor of each matrix, then put them into their place. We get a matrix. That matrix is called minor matrices or cofactor matrix. Again, I repeat. Minor is not calculate the complete matrix. We have to calculate for individual elements. And whenever we calculate the all minors of each individual, then put them into their place. And we get another matrix. That matrix is called minor matrix. And same for cofactor matrix. Minor matrix and cofactors are both are same. Only the difference is their sign. What are the sign and how we choose the sign? Let's we discuss here. Firstly, you know about how we calculate the minor. Firstly, we have to calculate the minor of our first element. This element is your A11. It means first row and first column. Same process. Cross that row as well as that column which we want to calculate the minor. Here we calculate the minor of A11. It means we have to calculate the minor of 2. So we cross that row as well as column. If we cross that row, it means we have the elements 4 and 1. And if we cross that column, then we remains only single. It means if we cross first row and first column, but we get 1. It means minor of A11 is 1. Again, we have to calculate the minor of 2. It means we have to cross row as well as column. But we will get 1. It means minor of a11 is equal to 1. Now we have to calculate the minor of 3. Minor of 3 has position first row and second column. So first row eliminate and second column eliminate. Remaining elements is your 4. Same, if we calculate the minor of 4, then what we will get? Cross that row and that column, what we will get? 3. Similarly, A22 is equal to 2. This one is your minors. Same as that we are done in determinants. Cross that row and that column and remaining elements you have to write. That is your minor. And the cofactor is also same. But the difference is what? Please make a note. We have calculated the cofactors of A11, A12, A21, A22. Elements not will be changed. Their sign change. Again, I repeat, the cofactors doesn't change the element value, but it changes the sign. And which element change the sign or which element doesn't change its sign? Elements are 1, 4, 3, 2. This sign will be positive or negative. How we will check? We have to use a formula. Minus 1 ki whole power I plus j. I indicates your row and j indicates your column. You have to put them here. Suppose minus 1 whole power I. Row is 1 and column is 1. It means 1 plus 1. And minus 1 ki whole power 2 into 1, which is equal to positive 1. Same here, negative 1 whole power 1 plus 2, which is equal to minus 1 ki whole power 3 into 4. And which this is your negative, you get negative. Now same, minus 1 ki whole power 2 plus 1, also minus 1 ki power 3 into 3, which is also negative. A22, minus 1 ki whole power 2 plus 2, which is equal to minus 1 ki whole power 4 into 2, which is equal to positive 2. In this manner we take its sign. You have to know or keep in mind minus 1 ki whole power I plus j. I indicates your row and j indicates your column. In this manner we take the sign. So minor and cofactors have same elements but sign are changed. And what's elements that have changed in sign? We have to calculate according to this formula. I hope this will be clear to you. Please make a note first. And also keep in mind, this is the long method whenever you calculate the cofactors. It is a shortcut method. Whenever you calculate in rough work, not in final exam or in your fair notebook, then you can use its shortcut. What's are the shortcut? Firstly, I have right here some sign assumption, positive, negative, to take same assumption here. Positive, negative. It means here that matrix is of order of 2 into 2. It means we have this position. Positive sign indicate that sign will be same. It means this element is positive. It means this sign will be remain same. It means positive 1, your final. Now, second in one is also. Are you getting my points? This is your first minor. And this position is 2. And here position is positive. So we take sign positive. if you find sign negative, negative means you have to change the sign of the minor. Here we get the minor of A12 is 4, then change the sign, which is minus 4. Now A21, this one is and this sign is negative, it means we have to change the sign. This is positive 3, so we have to change sign negative 3. Similarly, A22, this has positive, it means we have not changed the sign, positive 2, so it will remain positive, as you say there. This is your shortcut method whenever you solve in your competition. Please make a note first. Okay, let me take another example to calculate the minor and cofactor of a square matrix having order 3 cross 3. So this is your matrix and we have to calculate, our first question is calculate the minor. So the same process, firstly we have to calculate the minor of A11, it means we have to cross that row as well as that column and to write the remaining elements. If we cross this row, it means this will be cross and that column is this, then what are the remaining elements? Is we cross first row and cross first column, the remaining elements are 3, 4. You have to write in terms of determinants, 3, 4, 2, 2, and solve this. 3 into 2 6, minus 4 into 2 8, which is equal to minus. Same as if we take 2, this row will cancel, column cancel out, this row cancel out, the remaining elements are 4. This is your A11. Now we calculate A12. Your this element cross that row as well as that column. What are the remaining elements? 2, 4, 1, 2. Now calculate 2 into 2 4, minus 4 into 1 4, which is equal to 0. Now calculate your third A13. This is cross that row as well as that column, the remaining elements are 2, 3, 1, 2. 2 into 2, 4, minus 3 into 1, 3, which is equal to 1. Now A21, this is, this column row will be, we have to cancel out, as well as this column we have to cancel out. The remaining elements are 2, 1, 2, 2. Solve this, 2 2's are 4, minus 2 into 1, 2, which is equal to 2. Now A22 means 3, we cancel out row as well as column, the remaining elements are 1, 1, 1, 2, 2 into 1, 2, minus 1 into 1, 1, which is equal to 1. A23, second row, third column, if we cancel out this, the remaining elements are 1, 2, 1, 2, 2 into 1, 2, 1 into 2, 2, 2 minus 2, 0. A31, this row and this column, then the remaining elements are 2, 1, 3, 4, 2 into 4, 8, 3 into 1, 3, 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. So now this row and this column, what are the remaining elements? 1, 1, 2, 4, 4 into 1, 4, minus 2 into 1, 2, which is equal to 2. A33 means this element, cross this row and this column, what are the remaining elements? 1, 2, 2, 3. Now say 3 into 1, 3, minus 2 into 2, 4, which is equal to minus 1. These all are the minors. If we put all the minors into the matrix having same corresponding their position, we get a matrix which is called minor matrix. Now we have to find cofactor. This is your second part. We have to calculate the cofactor of this matrix. Now we apply the shortcut tricks. What are the shortcut trick? First sign you are positive. This is your positive. It means positive, negative, positive. We use the same convention: positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, negative, positive, positive. Same convention. First, our element is A11 is -2 because first element is positive. Sign is same. A12. Second sign negative. It means we have to change the sign. 12 has 0 and 0 has no sign, negative, negative. A13. A13 has 1. 13 has this position, which is equal to positive. It means we have to retain the sign. Or you can more easily to find out the cofactor signs, you have to use this to add up this. If this result is even, you get the positive sign. It means you not change the sign of the minor. If addition is odd, it means you have to change the sign. Now we calculate A21, which is odd. It means we have to change the sign. This is 2. We get change the sign, -2. A22, positive, even. It means no change the sign. 1 as it is. 2, 3. Odd means change the sign. 0 has no sign. 3, 1. 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. Means even, not change the sign. 3 plus 2, 5, which is odd. It means change the sign. Here sign is 2. So we change the sign. -2. A33. 3 plus 3, 6. Even, it means positive. We not change the sign. Negative 1. This is your answer. If we put these elements into the matrix, we get a matrix which is called cofactor matrix. I hope this will be clear to you. Please make a note, please. So next topic is singular matrix or non-singular matrix. A matrix is said to be singular matrix if the determinant of the matrix is equal to 0. Otherwise, the matrix is non-singular. Again, I repeat that you have to check any matrix is singular or non-singular. You have to take its determinant. If you get the determinant is equal to 0, it means that matrix is singular. Otherwise, the matrix is non-singular. Here I take an example. A matrix has an element 2, 3, 2, 3. If we take this determinants, 3 into 2, 6. 2 into 3, 6. 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. So this matrix is called singular matrix. Otherwise, this matrix will be a non-singular matrix. So please make a note. So let's start our questions of element mathematics. I take some questions and forget repeated question or same question. You have to do same question at yourself. Please make a note. So now we are doing our first question, and I have take 3 parts of the first question. Expand the following determinant. It means it is a determinant of 2 cross 2, and we have to use the forward cross product minus reverse cross product to evaluate the determinant. So let's we apply on this. This is your forward product, A plus iota B multiply A minus iota B minus reverse product, C plus iota D multiply minus C plus me iota D. This is A plus iota B or A minus iota B, which means A plus B and A minus B, which is equal to A square minus B square. Apply on this. A square minus b square. Here, if we take negative common, then it becomes positive, and this becomes c minus iota d, and this remains the same. A square minus iota square b square plus a plus b a minus b again a square minus b square c square minus iota d square. A square we know iota square is equal to negative 1, it means negative negative, positive same here, c square here we also get iota square and negative 1, so this becomes also positive. This means a square plus b square plus c square plus d square is your final answer. Now take second question, same manner, forward product sin 10 multiplied cos 80 minus reverse product, reverse is minus cos 10 into sin 80, negative negative sign becomes positive, sin 10 degree cos 80 degree plus cos 10 degree into sin 80 degree. Now this becomes the form sin cos cos sin, it means sin a plus b, 10 degree plus 80 degree which is equal to sin 90 degree and sin 90 degree is equal to 1. This will be your final answer. Apply this cross product, log of b to the base a multiply log of a to the base b minus 1 into 1, 1. And we know about the logarithm, log of a to the base b, it can be write as log of a to the base log b, we can write it as, apply this log b divided by log a multiply log a divided by log b minus 1, log b cancel out, log a c log a cancel out, 1 minus 1 which is equal to 0. This one is your answer. Please make up now. Now we take our second question. Say find the values of x in the following. It means this is a determinant which is equal to 3 and we have to calculate the values of x. Simply because it has given and we have to know about the how to solve the determinants. First we multiply it x minus 2 multiplied with 2x forward product minus reverse product minus 3 multiplied by 3x, 2x into x which is equal to 2x square minus 2x into 2 minus 4x minus minus positive 3 into 3 9x which is equal to 3, 2x square minus 9, 4 plus 9 is plus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now solve to make up factors. 2x square plus 6x minus x minus 3 is equal to 0. Take 2x as a common, x plus 3 negative as a common, x plus 3 is equal to 0. So factors that we are got here 2x minus 1 and x plus 3 is equal to 0. So here x is equal to 1 by 2 and x is equal to negative 3. It means it has two values, either it is to be minus 1 by 2, 1 by 2 or second is minus 3. These are the two values which is possible according to this question. Now look at third question is find the values of x so that the given matrix is singular. And we know about the singular matrix, any matrix whose determinant is 0. It means we have to calculate its determinant and put equal to 0. After that solve, we get the values of x. Okay, so we take its determinant is equal to 0. मल्टीप्लाई 5 माइनस एक्स इंटू 4 फॉरवर्ड प्रोडक्ट माइनस रिवर्स प्रोडक्ट 2 इंटू एक्स प्लस 1 इज इक्वल टू 0 मल्टीप्लाई दिस 20 माइनस 4x माइनस 2x एंड माइनस 2 इज इक्वल टू 0 20 माइनस 2 18 माइनस 6x इज इक्वल टू 0 मीन्स x इज इक्वल टू 3 दिस वन इज योर फाइनल आंसर प्लीज मेक अ नोट सो वी टेक अवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एग्जाम क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 राइट द माइनस and the cofactors of each elements of the first column. It means we have take this first column of the following matrix and evaluate its determinant. It means it has three parts. First we have to calculate minor, then we have to calculate its cofactor, and then we have to calculate its determinants along first column. So we do one by one. Firstly, we have calculate minor of A11. Minor of A11 is your this. Cut that row and that column. What we will get? B, C, A, C, A, B and expand it. Cross multiply forward. Which is equal to a b square minus a c square. Now minor of a12. This one a12, not a12, it's a21 because we are expanding along c1. We take this element. Now cross that row and that column. What are the remaining elements? A, B, C, C, A, B. Solve it. A square B minus B, C square. Now expand A, 3, 1. Means this row and this column. Remaining elements are A, B, C, B, C. Solve it. A square C minus B square C. These are the minus. Are you getting my points? Now it's very easy to write its cofactor. We know. But we have to change the sign and those elements weights will remain same. Now cofactors of A11. We know matrices positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive. It means first we have to take first element which is equal to positive. It means not change the sign. AB square minus A C square. Second is your A21. Negative. It means we have to change the sign. If we change the sign, then what we will get? This becomes negative and this becomes positive. B C square minus A square. Third is your A31. Positive. It means sign will remain same. A square C minus B square C. These are your cofactors and these are your minus. Now we have calculated its determinants. The same process. Please make a note first. Now we have to calculate this determinant along first column. So firstly we have to write its elements 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 1. And we have to sign positive, negative and positive. Positive, negative, positive. Now use parallel lines. We draw parallel. Now take first elements, cross that row and that column. What we will get? B, C, A, C, A. Now we take second elements, remove this and remove this, what we will get? A, B, C, C, A. Now remove third row and first column, what we will get? A, B, B, C, C, A. Now expand this. A square B minus AC square minus A square B minus BC square plus A square C minus B square C. AB square minus AC square negative minus A square B, and this sign will be changed. BC square plus A square C minus B square C. All the terms are different, so they are not cancelled each other. So that's your final answer. Please make a note. Now we take our next question. This question number is your 10th. It's very important because this question has some property, and that property based question is always and mostly put up in your final exam. What will be that property? Please keep in mind and make a note please. K into A, determinant of A is equal to K whole power N into determinant of A, where K is any scalar number. Example, 5 into A determinant is equal to 5 whole power N multiply into A determinant, where N is order of the square matrix. This make a note first. K into A, K is your scalar number. If any scalar number is multiplied with any matrix and we have to take the determinants, then scalar number will come out to the determinants, and the whole power is n. N is the order of the square matrix. If a matrix is of order 2 into 2, it means the values of n is equal to 2. Here, the order of the matrix is 3. It means this is a matrix of order 3 into 3. So we have n is equal to 3. So if we apply on this, 3A determinant is equal to 3. 3 is a scalar number which will come outside of the determinants, and the power is n into determinant of A, which is equal to 3. N is equal to 3 into A determinant, which is equal to 27 into A determinant. This is equal to. Such type of question becomes 1 mark question in your final exam. But here we have to prove this. So we don't follow this step. Please make a note first. Now we have to solve left hand side is equal to right hand side. Left hand side is equal to 3A determinant. It means firstly we have to multiply 3 to A matrices. 3 multiply A. 3 into 1, 3, 0, 3, 0, 3, 6, 0, 0, 12. Now we have to take its determinant. 3A determinant. It means 3, 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 3, 6, 12. And we know how we solve that. Firstly, we write this element. Now let's expand along R1. So write the elements 3, 0, 3. Use parallel lines. Use sign positive, negative, positive. Positive, negative, positive. Remove first row and first column. What we will get? 3, 6, 0, 12. Second column, second row, 0, 6, 0, 12. थर्ड कॉलम थर्ड रो 0 3 0 0 3 12 इंटू 3 36 माइनस 6 इंटू 0 0 माइनस 0 मल्टीप्लाई दिस वी गेट 0 प्लस 3 0 माइनस 3 इंटू 0 0 इट मींस 36 इंटू 3 इज वी गेट 108 दिस इज आवर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड नाउ वी हैव टू सॉल्व द राइट हैंड साइड The right-hand side is 27 into A determinant. It means, firstly we have to calculate the determinant of A. 27 into A. A matrix is 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 0, 0, 4. Same step. Firstly, write elements 1, 0, 1. Positive, negative, positive. First row, first column, what we will get? 1, 2, 0. Second column, second row, 0, 2, 0, 4. Third column, third row, 0, 1, 0, 1. 27 multiply 1. 4 into 1, 4. Minus 0 multiply this, 0. Plus 0 into 1, 0. 1 into 0, 0. Which is equal to 1, 0. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. So we prove that. So we complete our exercise 4.1. Please do it in your final or fair notebook. If any query, please comment on my ID. Thank you for that.